Okay, so today I'm going to talk about when you have this whole host of choices between straight edges, which ones are going to get you the best true verticals and horizontals. So let's take a look down at the page, and I'm going to show you some pros and cons of each one and tell you which one is my favorite to use. Okay, so between these, we've got a T-square, a triangle, a gridded ruler, and the cork-backed regular metal ruler. So let's talk about which ones I don't use and why. I don't use the T-square very often, and that's because you really have to have a side that you can catch this on in order to be able to get this to show you a truly horizontal or a truly vertical. And when you don't have a good edge of your drawing paper, or you know, you don't, like, say you have a really big table like way out here, I would have to catch it on this edge, which you guys can't even see. That's not going to be very useful, and I can try to catch it on the edge of the paper, but most often it's going to slip. So I don't use the T-square too often. The triangle works to get you a nice edge here, where you can line this up with your edge vertically, and then ideally it would get you a perfect horizontal. But what I find is that it slides just ever so slightly, and even when I just have a bare edge here where there's just a tiny bit of difference, that gets me a crooked line too. So I don't use the triangle that often. With my younger students, I do use this cork-backed ruler because they always have a hard time getting the ruler to lay flat and to stay in one place. So I do use these a lot with my younger students. But for my students who are 10 and older, the gridded ruler is going to be your best method for getting a perfectly horizontal line and a perfectly vertical line. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna slide this down here so you guys can see. I was drawing this dream catcher with a student of mine, an adult student, and I was using the gridded ruler, but let's check my work and see if it actually came out. So I'm gonna grab a sharpened pencil here, throw it around a little bit. And you might see that I have to lean my head in sometimes in order to make sure. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to look at this edge here of my red line on the grid, and I want to make sure that that red line is matched up perfectly with the edge of my paper. I'm going to trust that the edge of my paper is perfectly vertical. And so if I can line up this grid with a true vertical, that's going to give me a true horizontal. So now when I slide it up, and again, I'm going to have to put my head in the way just for a second to make sure it's perfect, I can actually see that my horizontal was not perfectly horizontal here. So I can redraw that. And you can see it just overlapped ever so slightly, so it really wasn't that far off. And then I can do the same on the top, line it up with the edge here on my left side. I can double check on my right side. If it's perfectly matched with the grid, it will be easier. And right now it's in between two grid lines, but I can really look at that distance that that white edge falls between the two grid lines over here to see if that helps me to line it up. And then I can draw my true horizontal line. You can do the same thing if you're going to a vertical line. You're just going to match up the grid with the edge of your horizontal paper, or the bottom edge of the horizontal of the paper, and then that gives you a perfectly vertical line. So the gridded ruler, as long as it's not moving around too much with a smaller child or a younger child who might not be able to hold it in place quite as perfectly, this is gonna be my favorite method for getting a true horizontal and getting a true vertical, which we know that we need a lot in drawing, and it's a difficult thing to achieve. So get yourself one of these cheapy gridded rulers. The one thing I will let you know is that if you live someplace warm like I do, they'll melt in your car, so don't keep them in your car. Other than that, they're great. Hope this tip helps you guys out, and let me know if you have any questions in the comments below. Thank you all so much for watching. Make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel, LZM Studio, where I frequently release quick tips and all kinds of different ideas about drawing. Also check out my Facebook and my Instagram page. I like to show photographs of my artwork, of my students' artwork, and share funny stories from my students on those pages. And then check out my website, lzmstudio.com, where you're going to find more inspiration and full-length, detailed tutorials.